रघुपति राघव राजाराम अति पावन सीताराम रघुपति राघव राजाराम अति पावन
Krishna. Oh. piercing the tree that you got there.
主罗马创作出显现在最早年代灵气年代。
But he's not a yoga avatar, he's a lila avatar.
他不是 yoga avatar, 他不是年代化身，他是逍遥化身 lila avatar.
So Lord Ramachandra appeared as the eldest son in the family of great King Maharaj Dasara.
他是出生在一个伟大的国王Lasana Dasara Maharaj 的长子。
Maharaj Dasara was a great king, powerful king, and he had three wives. One was called Gosalya, one was called Sumitra, and one was called Kaikeyi.
Dasara Maharaj is a great king, a very powerful king. He had three wives. The first wife was Gosalya, the second wife was Sumitra, and the third wife was Kaikeyi.
So.He got a benediction, and he had no children for a long time. And you know, as a king, it's very bad if you don't have children.
他当国王后好久都没儿子。对一个国王来说，如果没儿子，那可是很惨的事儿。没儿子
means nobody to take the throne, right, for the king.
因为没有人继承王位，这不是缺德事儿。
So he got somehow after a long time, he got the blessings and.Got some blessings from some sages, and the wives all became pregnant.
然后长久之后，他得到了一个圣人的祝福，妻子都怀孕了。
The oldest wife, Kaikeyi, she gave birth to Lord Ramachandra.
他的这个第一个妻子考萨里亚，考萨里亚生了祖罗马。
And the youngest wife, Kaikeyi, she is the mother of Bharat.
最小的妻，年轻的妻子凯基，她是巴尔塔的母亲。
And the other wife, Sumitra, she was the mother of Lakshman and Shatrughna.
第二个妻子苏米特是这个拉克斯曼和萨楚格纳的母亲。
Sometimes it's said these four sons are Vasudev Sankarsan, Aniruddha, and Prajumna.
通常说这四个儿子是 Vasudeva, Sankarsan, Aniruddha, and Prajumna.
Anyway, the Lord appeared, and actually the purpose in the Lord coming is to fulfill the need of the demigods.
其实神呐、啊，不，主来化身显现他的目的呢，就是要满足半神人。
There was a great demon, powerful demon named Ravan, and the demigods couldn't do anything about it.
这个有当时有一个邪恶的国王 Ravan， 半神人对他无计可施，无能为力。
This Ravan had become so powerful, no demigod could oppose him.
这个 Ravan 特别有力量，半神人对反抗他反抗不了。
He obtained benedictions that no demigod would ever harm him.
因为他得到祝福，半神人对他搞不定他。
But he was such a proud demon, he didn't take a blessing to get protection against any human.
但他这个恶魔太骄傲了，都没要什么祝福，没要那个受到人类的这个保护的这个祝福。
He thought no humans could ever trouble me.
因为他认为这个人呐、啊、没我有力量，不会给我造麻烦的，所以他没要这个祝福。
So this is why the demigods think.We ask the Lord to appear in the human form.
这就是为什么半神人祈求主啊，以人的形象显现的原因。
So Lord Ramachandra is known as the Mayata Avatar.
Mayata. 所以主的为什么他的名字叫 Mayata?
Mayata.
Mayata 啊，化身。
Yeah, Mayata means etiquette.
Mayata 的意思是礼仪。
Lord Ramachandra very strictly follows the etiquette in dealing with others.
这个 Ramachandra 严格遵守与他人交往的这个礼仪。
He is the best son. He's the best possible son you could ever get for a father.
他是一个无论你对父亲怎么好，是最好那个最优秀的儿子。
He was very obedient to whatever his father would say.
无论他父亲说什么，他都是一个恭顺的儿子，是个孝子，大孝子。
And he was also, of course, very dutiful king, and he took perfect care of his kingdom.
他又是一个美丽的这个国王，他对他的臣民是统治非常好。
He took so much care.
非常照顾他们。
He took care that nobody had any complaints.
他照顾他们国民好到什么程度？没有人来能投诉和抱怨。
And he had when he was the king, when he was ruling the kingdom, this is after his exile. When he came back from the forest, he became the king.
就他从森林被放逐归来以后，他当了这个国王这个统治期间。
So he had the rule that anybody can come to complain if something is not right in the kingdom, they should come and tell me.
他就定了一个规矩，无论谁。任何人对这个国王的统治有任何抱怨投诉的话都可以来见他。
So, usually nobody would come.
一般来说人想见国王那没戏。
But then it happened one day, a dog came.
但有一天发生一个事儿，一只狗来投诉了，狗来抱怨来
了。And Lakshman wasn't sure what to do because usually don't bring dogs into the home.
因为这拉斯曼就想，一般来说狗不得入内，不得入房间。他来投诉，那咋办呢？
So he told Lord Ramachandra, and he just said, "Off there, it's come."
那不管怎地，拉斯曼就告诉了嘛，一只狗来了，到底咋办
？So Lord Rama said, "You have to bring him in."
啊，主拉玛说，你得把他带进来。虽然不让他进房，还得带。
So, Lord Ramachandra asked the dog, "Yes, what's the problem?"
然后 Ramachandra 对狗说，咋回事？有啥问题说吧。
And the dog said, "You can see my head. It's been beaten. My skull has been broken."
完了，你看我的头。被打得骨折了，你看我脑袋被削了。这狗说指自己脑袋，你看到了吗？我的脑袋。
Lord Rama said, "What happened? Who did this?"
完了 ，Rama 问，发生了什么了？谁干的？这事儿是谁干的
？So the dog said, "This one Brahmana, his name was Sarva Artha Siddha."
Sarva Artha Siddha， 这个是一个婆罗门的名字。他说，就这个婆罗门。打的我。
So Lord Ramachandra immediately sent his servant, "Go bring this Brahmana here."
然后 Rama 立即派仆人把那个婆罗门给叫了过来。
So they brought the Brahmana and they asked him. Lord Rama asked him, "So, did you do this to the dog?"
然后 Rama 就问他，你对那个狗这事儿都是你干的吗
？And the Brahmana said, "Well." He said, "You know, I was begging, and nobody was giving me any food to eat, and I was hungry."
你知道吗？我在乞讨吃的，没有人给我吃的，我饿死了。
And it came time, the time for begging was past. The time was over for begging. I couldn't beg anymore, and I hadn't got any food. I was hungry.
乞讨的时间过去了。我还连个食儿都没弄到，我饿死了，没吃的。
And then this dog was blocking my path.
而这条狗居然挡了我的路，
so、
挡我道。
So I beat it on the head with my stick.
所以我就用我的棍子狠狠敲这个狗脑袋。
And then I was angry.
所以他就很生气嘛，婆罗门就生气嘛。
I was angry and I hit him.
我生气了，所以给他胖揍了一顿。
So Lord Ramachandra asked all the ministers who were there and all his assistants and secretaries and brahmanas, "What should we do?"
所以当时呢，有这些他的秘书啊、婆罗门呐、大臣都在场。Rama 就问他，
said,
这事怎么处理
？They said, "Well, he's a brahmana. You cannot do any punishment on a brahmana."
完了说，大臣说，这是婆罗门。你对婆罗门可不能惩罚呀。
But he's done wrong.
但他还做犯错了。
How will we deal with him?
您那怎么处理呢
？So Lord Rama said, "We will make him the head of the monastery. Put him in charge of the monastery where all the monks live."
这样吧，我们任命他当庙的庙长的头吧，当个头，当庙长。
And the dog said, "Yes, that's a good idea."
哇，这狗一听，太好了，这主意棒极了，一流的主意了。
And they were surprised. They said, "Really, you think this is a good idea?"
完了，人们就特别惊讶，这狗，这主意好吗？怎么那么好呢？
And the dog said, "Yes. In my last life, I was the head of the monastery."
因为我这狗说，因为我上辈子就是那个庙的庙长。
And now I've got this body of a dog.
我现在得了一个狗的身体呀。
So if we put him as the head of the monastery, he's got such a hot temper. He's got such a quick temper.He's going to get angry. He's going to offend a lot of people.
因为他当了庙长，他的脾气呢还特急，还特容易生气。他一旦当了庙长，他肯定会冒犯很多人的。
The dog said, "When I was the head of the temple, he said I wasn't so bad, but still I got the body of a dog."
所以我当庙长的时候，我干了老鼻子缺德事，所以我这辈子得到狗的身体。
But I don't know what if he becomes the head of the temple, he will go right into the darkest regions.
你如他当庙长了，他肯定投身在最黑暗的区域里头，肯定的，缺德事也少不了干。
So we should understand from this pastime that it's very dangerous to accept responsibilities.
这个故事告诉我们，你接受一个职责呀，特别重要。
To accept responsibility.
就接受一个职责，你担责的时候特别重要。
There are three different responsibilities which are very difficult.
有三种职责令人特别困难。
One is to take charge of deities.
第一个职责
the deity.
负责崇拜神像。
If you don't do the deity worship properly, you're going to get serious reactions.
如果你不认真的崇拜神像，你这个报应是很严重的。
Sometimes people don't understand the responsibility of bringing a deity into the home.
人们就不知道，你把神像带到你的家里，你还你崇拜神像，你不知道这个那就后果很严重。
They think, "Oh, it looks nice."
哎呀，这神像来我家，这神像这么漂亮，真好。
And they never take care to worship regularly.
但你不小心，也不照顾，也不崇拜，啊。
So you get reactions.
你会有报应的。
Another problem is if you have cows and you don't take care of the cows.
另外一个责任，第二个责任，你有养牛，你得保护它，那个牛，母牛。
You bring cows to your, under your care. You have a duty to look after them.
你的职责就是自己保护一下，还得照料这个母牛。
You have to make sure they get water and sufficient food.
你要确保它有水喝，新鲜的东西吃。
And you have to clean for them.
你还得给它清洁，给母牛清洁。
You have to clean up the stool all the time.
你还得清理它的牛粪。
It's a big responsibility.
巨大的责任呐。
People say, "Oh, so nice, have a cow."
你说，哎呀，有母牛太好了。
And then they don't think about taking care of the cow.
但你得照顾它呀，你光好不行，你得照顾人家。
And the third thing is taking care of an ashram.
第三个责任，你得造这个 ashram。
你要灵修所。You have devotees living in the ashram. You have to take care of them.
有奉献者住在这个灵修院，你得照顾他们。你得照顾。
You have to keep them happy.
你让他们开心，开开心心。
That's a responsibility.
这是一个巨大责任，你得有责任的。
So this man, this brahmana, he was easily angered.
所以这个婆罗门很容易生气，很容易发火。
So by putting him in charge of the temple, he'll get angry easily.
如果他当庙长，他容易生气，那可惨。
He's going to get a lot of trouble.
那麻烦大了，这个婆罗门就麻烦大了。
So that was a punishment.
所以这个是一种惩罚，怎么样？麻烦他
被。Okay. So that story that's told in the Valmiki Ramayana.
所以这个故事就是在 Valmiki Ramayana 里讲述的。
The Valmiki Ramayana is authorized Ramayana.
Valmiki Ramayana 是被授权的 Ramayana.
There are 24,000 Sanskrit verses in the Valmiki Ramayana.
在 Valmiki 的 Ramayana 之中有24,000个梵文诗节。
But the Valmiki Ramayana is only a very condensed version of the actual Ramayana, which has one billion verses.
但是我们的Valmiki的 Ramayana 是非常浓缩的版本的一个 Ramayana， 因为真正的 Ramayana 它包括十亿个梵文诗节。
Okay, so in the Valmiki Ramayana, every 1,000 verses, he begins with the one syllable from the Gayatri Mantra.
在 Valmiki Ramayana 之中呢，每一千个诗节，他开始这一千个诗节的时候，都会从 Gayatri Mantra 的一个音节开始。
In the Brahma Gayatri Mantra, there are 24 syllables.
在 Brahma Gayatri 之中，包括24个音节。
So every 1,000 verses begins with a different syllable, and this, the whole Gayatri Mantra is there within the Ramayana.
在每一千个诗节的开始，都会以一个 Gayatri Mantra 的音节开始，因此整个的 Ramayana 就包括了所有的这个 Gayatri Mantra.
So Lord Ramachandra's appearance is coming to satisfy the desire of the demigods to deal with this demon Ravana.
主让权者的显现是为了能够去消灭那些恶魔，能够就是说给这个 Ravana 进行。
So in order for Lord Ramachandra to deal with this demon Ravana, the demigods arranged that he would have to go and live in the forest.
为了能够跟Ravana 打交道，所以那些人就安排他必须要住在森林里。
So the demigods arranged, they began to speak through.Different people through, like, there was one lady called Mantara who was the maid servant of Kaikeyi.
于是半神人安排不同的人去通过这样的人去讲话，其中有一个人叫做 Mantara， 她是 Kaikeyi 的女仆。
Mantara was a hunchback lady who lived in the palace, and she was a very faithful servant of Kaikeyi.
Mantara 是一个驼背的女人，她作为一个仆人是 Kaikeyi 的非常忠诚的女仆。
And Kaikeyi was the youngest wife of the three wives, so Maharaj Dasarath had great affection for her.
Kaikeyi 是三个妻子之中最年轻的一位，所以 Maharaj Dasarath 对她有特别的感情。
And so it happened, the four brothers were all married, and after they got married, it was arranged that Bharat and Shatrughna would go to their uncle's place.
四个兄弟全都结婚了，等到结婚了之后呢，巴尔和沙楚呢被安排去他们的叔叔或者是舅舅的地方。
There are four brothers. Lakshman was always with Rama. Shatrughna was always with Bharat.
一共有四个兄弟 ，Lakshman 一直跟 Rama 在一起，而沙楚呢一直跟巴尔特在一起。
And they were all married together.
他们全都是一起结婚的。
And it happened that after the marriage, they come back to Ayodhya.And then Maharaj Dasarath asked Bharat and Shatrughna to go with their wives to go and visit the kingdom of the father of Kaikeyi.
他们结了婚之后全都回到了 Ayodhya， 而 Maharaj Dasarath 就要求 Shatrughna 和 Bharat 去访问 Kaikeyi 的这个国度，他们的娘家乡南京。
So it happened that while they were away, that time Maharaj Dasarath decided.That he was very old and he may die at any time, so he wanted to crown Lord Rama as the prince, that he would become the king.
他们还在半路的时候，马哈迪达斯拉他就决定自己已经非常年迈了，在任何时候都有可能死亡，于是他想让 Rama 加冕为王。
And it happened that Maharaj Dasarath began to make arrangements for Ram to be coronated to become the king, and he didn't inform.Bharat and Shatrughna.
Maharaj Dasarath 于是做出安排为 Rama 举行加冕典礼，但是他并没有通知 Bharat 还有 Shatrughna.
And all the kings started to come to attend the big coronation. It's going to be a very big function.
所有的国王都来参加加冕典礼，这是一个很盛大的典礼。
And that night, just before the coronation, Mantara went to Kaikeyi, and she told Kaikeyi that.
This is very inauspicious. This is very dangerous for you.
就在那天晚上 ，Mortimer 去找 KK， 他说这个是非常不吉祥的，对于你而言，这个是非常危险的。
Your son Bharat will not be in any position. If Ram becomes a king, then Bharat will not have any importance in the kingdom.
如果要是 Ram 成为国王的话，那你的儿子 Bharat 将没有任何的地位，他在王国之内将没有任何的重要性可言。
And if Ram becomes a king, his mother will become the mother of the king. Her position will be more important than your position.
如果他要是成为了国王，他的母亲的地位就会变得比你的地位要重要得多。
So Kaikeyi, initially Kaikeyi did not accept, and she thought, "No, I love Ram. It's very nice. He's wonderful. I like him."
他一开始的时候，Kaikeyi并不接受。他说：“我爱 Ram。”
Lord Rama was very careful in dealing with the three mothers. She dealt with them all equally.
Rama 对待所有的母亲都非常的仔细，他对待所有的母亲都是很平等的。
But Mantara was influenced by the demigods, and she spoke so cunningly. She influenced the mind of Kaikeyi.
但是 Mantara 受到了半仙人的影响，所以呢，他就不断的讲，于是影响到了 Kaikeyi 的心意。
And she told Kaikeyi, "You're going to be in trouble if Ram becomes a king. You have no position. You'll be exiled. Nobody will want you. Nobody will respect you."
他告诉 Kaikeyi 说，如果要是 Ram 成为国王的话，那你就会被流放，没有人会尊敬你，你就没有任何的重要性了。
So this was unusual, but it was the arrangement of the demigods, so that the whole Leela could unfold.
这是非常不同寻常的，但实际上这是半神人们的安排，于是这个 Leela 逍遥时光可以被展示出来。
So it happened that Maharaj Dasarath came to see Kaikeyi. Every evening he would come to see Kaikeyi. She was the youngest wife, she was very beautiful.And Maharaj Dasarath would come there every evening to see her.
Maharaj Dasarath 每天晚上都会来见 Kaikeyi， 因为她是所有妻子之中最年轻的一位，而且她非常的美貌。于是晚上的时候 ，Maharaj Dasarath 来见她。
So when he came to see her, she was not in her room. Instead, she had entered the morning room.
而当 Maharaj 到来的时候，发现她不在自己的房间里。大家说她去了这个哀悼室。
And Maharaj Dasarath wondered what was wrong, and he went to see her and was surprised to see her laying on the floor with all her ornaments scattered around and her hair disheveled, and she was all looking very disturbed and unhappy.
Maharaj Dasarath 就去看到底是怎么回事，结果发现他躺在地上，他所有的首饰洒落了一地，而且呢头发也乱糟糟的，他非常的悲哀。
So Maharaj Dasarath comes and he pleads with her, "Tell me what you want. What can I give you? I will give you everything, anything you want. You just have to ask me."
Maharaj Dasarath 就问他说，你怎么了？请你告诉我，我到底应该给你点什么？你想要什么都可以，一切你想要的我都可以给你。
So then Kaikeyi sits up and then she looks at her husband.And she said, "Do you remember that one time you were fighting in a battle and you got injured?"
Kaikeyi 坐了起来，他对着 Maharaj Dasarath 说，你记得吗？曾经有一次在战争之中，你受了伤。
That time I came there and I rescued you and I drove your chariot away and brought you back out of you were unconscious. I brought you back to consciousness.And you were so grateful to me. You promised me you would give me 2 benedictions.
在那个时候，我驾驶着战车救了你，我把你救出来，然后让你从昏迷之中醒了过来。你非常的感激我，你答应我要给我两个祝福。
So Maharaj Dasarath said, "Yes. What do you want? No problem. I will give you the 3 worlds."
Maharaj Dasarath 说，是的，你想要什么？我可以给你三个世界。
So Kaikeyi said, "No, I simply want that instead of Ram becoming coronated, I want my son Bharat to be coronated."
他可以说，与其让 Rama 成为就是被加冕为王的话，我想让我的儿子 Bharat 被加冕为王。
And let Ram go and live in the forest for 14 years.
让 Rama 去森林里住十四年。
And Maharaj Dasarath just fainted, fell on the ground.
Maharaj Dasarath 晕过去了，他倒在地上。
Because Lord Ram was the most dear of all the children to him, the most dear of all the sons, he was the most lovable object to Maharaj Dasarath.
因为在所有的儿子之中 ，Ram 是最受到真爱的一位，是 Maharaj Dasarath 最喜欢的一个。
And he could not imagine that he could ever live without his son Ram.
他没有办法想象自己在没有 Ram 的情况之下还能活下去。
So he tried to plead with Kaikeyi, he pleaded with her, but she would not change.
于是他想努力地祈求凯凯伊，但是无论他怎么求，凯凯伊都不改变主意。
And she told her husband, "You're supposed to be famous for truthfulness."
她告诉她的丈夫说，你应该以真诚而著名。
If you cannot keep your word, what is the meaning to your truthfulness?
如果你不能信守你的诺言的话，你的真诚有什么意义？
You promised me 2 boons. I'm telling you what boons I want. You should arrange now.
我告诉你，因为你答应了要给我两个祝福，而我现在告诉了你我想要的祝福，所以你现在就应该马上安排。
Let Ram go and live in the forest for 14 years.
让 Rama 去森林里住十四年。
And my son Bharat will become the king.
而我的儿子 Bharat 会成为国王。
This is typical of family life.
这就是典型的家庭生活。
A lot of intrigues and arguments and politics.
很多的阴谋、政变还有政治。
Very difficult to satisfy people.
很难让人们满足。
Just look, Maharaj Dasarath, such a powerful king. He has so much power, so much wealth.
看看马哈迪达斯拉吧，他有这么多的力量，他是一个非常有力量的国王，他有很多的权力，很多的财富。
But, in order to satisfy this wife, he has to send Ram to the forest.
但是为了满足他的妻子，他不得不让 Ram 去森林。
So, Maharaj Dasarath, he didn't like to tell Ram, but Kaikeyi arranged it.They brought Ram there and he told, and Ram immediately, yes, father, I will go to forest.
Maharaj Dasarath 不想把这些事情告诉 Ram, 但是 Kaikeyi 他安排了所有的一切，他们让人把 Ram 带到了这里，然后 Ram 非常欣然接受，说是的，父亲，我可以马上就去森林。
Maharaj Dasarath said, when you go to the forest, we will send the whole kingdom with you. All the citizens will go with you.
马哈迪达斯拉说：“当你去森林的时候，我会派所有的村民们跟你一起去。我整个这个国度都会跟你一起。
All the shopkeepers, all the vendors, all the everybody will go with you to the forest.
所有的店主，所有的那些商贩，每一个人都会跟你一起去森林。
But Kaikeyi objected. She said, "Look, my son has to become the king of the kingdom. You cannot send the kingdom to the forest."
还可以反对，他说：“因为我的儿子要成为国王，他应该有一个国度，你不能让所有的人全都去森林。”
If everybody goes to the forest will become the kingdom.
如果要是每一个人都去了森林，森林就会成为王国。
And the kingdom, the our capital city Ayodhya will become like the forest.
而王国，我们的首都 Ayodhya 就会变成森林。
So anyway, it was arranged.Ram has to go to forest, and when Ram tells that he's going to forest, then Lakshman said, "I'm also coming with you."
于是安排 Ram 要去森林里接受流放。当 Ram 要去森林的时候，他的弟弟 Lakshman 说，哦，我也要跟你一起去。
Because wherever Lord Rama was going, Lakshman was always accompanying him. They were always together. They were inseparable.
因为无论 Ram 去什么地方 ，Lakshman 都跟他在一起，总是陪伴着他，他们是不可分开的。
And then when Sita heard.She said, "I'm also coming too."
当西特听说的时候，他说我也要去。
Lord Rama wasn't very eager to take his wife with him.
主拉玛其实并不太想带他的妻子跟他一起去。
But she was very eager, very determined. No, I have to come with you.
但他非常的迫切，他非常的有决心，不，我一定要去。
I cannot stay here for 14 years on my own.
我不能自己在这儿过十四年。
I will come with you to the forest.
我也要跟你一起去森林。
So the three of them, they then addressed in the bark of trees, and they matted their hair, and they went to the forest.
于是他们三个人穿着树皮做的衣服，把头发都打成结，去了森林。
And so initially they enjoyed very much. They enjoyed very nice in the forest, very beautiful. So many nice flowers and fruits and many wild vegetables and roots. And they were living very comfortably.
一开始他们非常喜欢森林的氛围，他们很喜欢森林里有各种的鲜花，有水果，有野菜，还有野生的根茎类植物。他们在森林里过得非常的舒适。
And they went to the ashrams of some of the great sages. Many great sages were living there in the forest, and they went to visit them.
他们还去不同的 ashram， 因为在森林之中住着很多的圣人。他们去这些圣人的 ashram 去访问他们。
And the sages understood this is Lord Ramachandra. He's the personality of Godhead.
圣人们都明白这位是主 Ramachandra， 他就是至尊人格守神。
And they were very respectful. They gave him all honor and respect.
每一个人都充满了敬意，以全部的、全然的敬畏之心去对待他。
So there were some difficulties. One of the difficulties was because Lakshman is a younger brother, he would try to make nice arrangements for the comfort of his older brother along with his wife.
有一些困难，这个困难就是 Lakshman 作为弟弟，他要必须为他的哥哥还有他的哥哥的妻子的舒适做出一些安排。
But Lord Rama would not accept. He wouldn't be happy with this.
但是 Rama 不接受，他对此觉得不高兴。
He said, "I come to the forest. I want to live like an ascetic. I don't want to live like a king in the forest."
他说，我到了森林里，我想做一个苦行者去生活。我并不是到森林里当国王来的。
So it was very painful for Lakshman.
对于 Lakshman 来讲，这是很痛苦的一件事情。
So he vowed. Lakshman vowed, "In future incarnations, I will come as an older brother."
于是拉什曼发誓，在未来的化身之中，我要作为大哥来。
And we see Balarama is the older brother.
我们可以看到 Balarama， 他是 Krishna 的哥哥。
Balarama serves Lord Krishna in all five different rasas.
Balarama 以所有五种不同的 rasa 服务 Krishna.
And Krishna cannot complain.
Krishna 不能抱怨。
Why? Balarama is
big. 因为 Balarama 他是哥哥，他说了算。
Remember?
记得吗？
道吉嘎巴呀，
道吉嘎巴呀
，Krishna Kanaya，
Krishna Kanaya，
道吉嘎巴呀，
道吉嘎巴呀
，Krishna Kanaya，
Krishna Kanaya，
道吉嘎巴呀，
道吉嘎巴呀
，Krishna Kanaya，
Krishna Kanaya，
道吉 means a big brother。
道吉的意思就是大哥。
And Kanaya is the younger brother.
Kanaya 是弟弟。
So Lakshman had a tough time. He's the younger brother.
Lakshman 过得很艰难，因为他是弟弟。
And then it happened one day, because in the forest there were also some rakshasas, so it happened that some rakshasas came there.
然后有一天，因为是在森林里，森林里有很多的 Rakshasa， 于是有一天，一个 Rakshasa 到了那个地方。
So this Rakshasa was Surpanaka.
这个 Rakshasa 的名字叫做 Surpanaka.
And Surpanaka came there in the form of a beautiful woman.
Surpanaka 以非常美丽的一个女子的形象到了那个地方。
And she saw Lord Rama.And she thought, "Wow, nice man! That he will make a nice husband for me."
她看到了 Rama， 这是一个好男人啊！这样好的男人应该可以给我当丈夫。
So she approached Lord Rama and said to Lord Rama, "You're a Kshatriya. You know, I'm a young woman. You should comfort me."
她去找 Rama 说：“你看，你是一个 Kshatriya， 而我是一个年轻的女子，你应该让我感到慰藉。”
Kshatriyas have a moral duty that they should accept a woman who comes to shelter to them for shelter.
Kshatriya 有一种道德的规则，也就是说，任何女人如果来托庇于他们的话，他们必须接受。
But Lord Rama said to her, "Oh," he said, "I'm sorry. Look, I have my wife here. You know." He said, "I'm already married. I have my wife."
但主 Rama 说，你看我已经结婚了，我的妻子就在这里，我已经有老婆了。
And usually Kshatriyas they can have many wives.
通常沙提亚可以有很多的妻子。
But Lord Rama is very special. He vowed only one wife.
但主 Rama 非常特殊，他发誓只娶一位妻子。
Ekapatni Vrat.
Ekapatni Vrat.
So.He said, anyway, he said, I'm a younger brother. Go to him.
他说无论如何，那边是我弟弟，你可以去找他。
So she saw Lakshman, and she went over to Lakshman, and she solicited Lakshman. You know, you should. I'm a young woman. You should satisfy my desires.
他于是去找 Lakshman, 他跟 Lakshman 就是在那跟他央求着说，你看呐，我是个年轻的女子，你应该满足我的愿望。
Lakshman said, oh, Mataji, he said, I'm just a younger brother, you know, you should go to the big brother. He's my brother.
Lakshman 说 oh, Mataji, 你看我只不过是弟弟而已，你应该去找我大哥。
I have no position, you know, I'm just an insignificant young brother.
我没有任何的地位，我只不过是一个微不足道的弟弟而已。
But my brother, my big brother, he will fulfill all your desires.
但是我大哥肯定能满足你所有的愿望。
So Supanika was becoming a little frustrated.
于是 Supanika 变得有点迷惑了。
And she turned to Sita and said, look, this woman, what kind of wife is she?
然后她转向 Sita 说，看这个女人，什么样的女人啊？什么样的妻子啊？
Look at me, I'm much nicer than her.
看看我，我比她强多了。
And she was not very nice to Mother Sita.
她对于西塔母亲表现的不是很友好。
And she tried to harm Mother Sita.
而且她试图去伤害西塔母亲。
So Lord Rama cut off her ears and nose.
于是主 Rama 砍掉了她的耳朵和鼻子。
And then she ran away screaming.
她尖叫着跑开了。
Because she was a Rakshasi, she was not.Just any ordinary woman. She was actually the sister of Ravan.
她其实不是一个普通的女人，她是一个 Rakshasi. 她实际上是 Ravana 的妹妹。
And she went running back to Ravan and told Ravan what happened.
她跑回到 Ravana 那里，告诉 Ravana 到底发生了什么。
So Ravana sent an army there to deal with Ram and Lakshman.
Ravana 就说，我们有一支军队可以应付 Rama 和 Lakshman.
But Lord Ramachandra killed the whole army, defeated the whole army.
但是呢 ，Rama 击败了整个的军队，他把整个的军队的人全杀了。
Killed all of the generals of Ravan.
杀死了 Ravan 的所有的将军。
Ravan was very surprised, very powerful.
Ravan 很惊讶，真是太有力量了。
So that, Supanika told Ravan, you know, she said, you know, this man in the forest, he's very great, very powerful, not an ordinary man. He's Ramachandra, the son of Dasarath. And she said to him that he has this wife who is very beautiful.
Supanika 告诉 Ravana, 他说这个人 Rama, 他实际上不是一个普通人，他的名字叫 Ramachandra, 是 Maharaj Dasarath 的儿子。而且他有一位妻子，非常的美丽。
And Ravana is very fond of beautiful women.
Ravana 非常喜欢美丽的女人。
And so when he heard she had a very beautiful wife, then Ravana was interested. He thought,
oh, imagine. 当 Ravana 听说哦，他有非常美丽的妻子的时候，就想着哦，我一定要去，我得到他的妻子。
So he got the help of Marichi. Marichi was a demon who had mystic powers. He could change form.
他得到了恶魔 Marichi 的帮助。Marichi 他有玄秘的力量，可以改换自己的形象。
And he told Marichi, "You have to help me. I want to kidnap this woman. I want to kidnap this man's wife."
他告诉 Marichi, 你必须要帮助我，我想要绑架这个人的妻子。
But Marichi was he didn't like to do it. He was reluctant to do this. He thought this is very, very bad thing to do.
Marichi 不想这么做，他不愿意做这件事情。他说这是一个不好的事情。
But Ravan told him, "Well, if you don't do it, I'll kill you."
但是 Ravan 告诉他说，如果你不做，我就杀了你。
So Marichi thought, "Better I get killed by Ram than killed by Ravan."
Marichi 就想，我还不如让 Ram 杀了我，要比让 Ravan 杀了我强多了。
Either way, I'm going to be killed, so let me be killed by Lord Ramachandra.
无论如何我都会被杀，所以还不如让我被主让搀着所杀。
And so in this way, Marichi took the form of the golden deer.
就这样
came there in the forest and Sita saw the deer and she's attracted.
这样 Marichi 他就改变自己的形象，变成了一头金色的鹿，到森林里去。Sita受到了这头金色的鹿的吸引。
So Lord Rama understood this is no ordinary deer, this is some kind of trick, and he went after the deer.
主拉姆知道这不是一头普通的鹿，这里一定有什么把戏在其中，于是他去追逐这头鹿。
And he ended up killing the deer, but when he killed the deer, at that time the deer called out, Marichi called out, Ram, oh no, Lakshman, Lakshman, Sita, help me.
结果他追上了这头鹿，把这头鹿杀了。就在临死的那一刻 ，Marichi 他变成了这头鹿，他在呼唤 ：“Oh, Lakshman, Sita, 救救我
！”So Lakshman and Sita were waiting back. Lord Ram had gone after the deer, and when Lakshman heard the voice, he knew this is a trick. This is not Ram. Nothing could happen to Lord Ram.
Lakshman 和 Sita 他们是留在后面的，但是当他们听到这个声音的时候 ，Lakshman 知道这是一个把戏，因为不可能有任何事情发生在 Ram 身上，这不可能是 Ram 他喊的。
But Mother Sita was not convinced.
但是 Sita 母亲不信服。
She said, "You're lusty after me."
她说你是对我有色欲。
You just want me. In the absence of your brother, you want to enjoy me. You don't care about your brother.
在你大哥不在的时候，你想享受我，你根本就不在乎你的哥哥。
In this way, she spoke very harsh words, very nasty words to Lakshman.
这样，她对 Lakshman 讲了非常尖刻、刻薄的话语。
Lakshman said, "I never look at your face. I only know your feet."
Lakshman 说，我从来都没有看过你的脸，我只知道你的脚。
But anyway, she told Lakshman, "You have to go see what's wrong with Lord Ram."
但无论如何 ，Sita 告诉 Lakshman 说，你一定要去看看 Ram 怎么样了。
So Lakshman went to find out what was wrong, but before he went, he put a circle around Mother Sita.
Lakshman 去看看到底发生了什么，但是在他走之前，他绕着 Sita 母亲画了一个圈。
And he told Mother Sita, "Don't come outside this circle."
他告诉西特母亲说：“不要跨过到这个圈子的外面去。
You stay in this circle, you'll be safe.
你待在这个圈子里，你就是安全的。
Just like all of us in practicing Krishna consciousness, we have to stay in this within the circle.
就像我们所有的人一样，我们在修习 Krishna 知觉，必须要待在这个圈子里。
Right, the circle is that the regulative principles of devotional service.
这个圈子便是奉献服务的规范原则。
If you don't follow the regulative principles, then you're coming outside that circle.
如果你要是不追随奉献服务的规范原则，你就到了这个圈子的外面。
And we're going to be subject to people like Ram.
然后我们会受制于像 Ram 这样的人的控制。
And also the modern day Suparnakas are also there.
还有现代的这些 Suparnaka， 他们也存在。
Modern day Suparnaka, women want to make themselves overly attractive.
现在的这些 Suparnaka， 也就是那些想让自己过分的有吸引力的女人。
They want to attract materialistic men.
他们想吸引物质主义的男人。
So Suparnakas are there all over the world.
所以全世界都有 Suparnaka.
And we have also Ravan.People like Ravan who are very greedy to exploit the opposite sex.
而且还有像 Ravan 这样的人，他们非常的贪婪，想去剥削异性。
So Ravan got rid of Lord Ram, and then Lakshman also went to look for Ram, and Mother Sita was left alone. At that time, Ravana came.
于是 Ravan 呢除掉了 Ram 不在他。然后呢，当 Sita 母亲一个人单独在的时候 ，Ravana 来了。
And he came disguised as a sadhu, as a holy man, a mendicant, and he's begging.
他假扮成一位圣人，一位 sadhu, 一位乞讨的托钵僧。
And Mother Sita sees him, and she wants to give him something.
Sita 母亲看到他之后，想给他一些东西。
And Ravana, he couldn't get in to say because she was protected by the circle. Lakshmana put a mystic circle around Mother Sita. Ravan could not enter that circle.
Ravana 他没有办法进到那个圈子里，是因为 Lakshman 在西塔母亲的周围画了一个神秘力量的圈子。
But then Mother Sita came outside the circle, and Ravana took Sita.
但后来西塔母亲出了这个圈子，于是 Ravana 就把西塔抢走了。
However, we should understand the actual Sita, Mother Sita.Has a purely spiritual form, and she could never be touched by a demon like Ravana.
然而，我们应该明白到，真正的西塔母亲，她有纯粹的、超然的灵性的形体，她是永远不能够受到 Ravana 的触碰的。
And it was Maya Sita who Ravana took.
Ravana 抢走的是 Maya Sita.
Ravana went off with the Maya Sita, took her off to Lanka.
Ravana 带走了假的 Maya Sita, 带着她去了 Lanka.
Ram and Lakshman come back and they find Sita's gone.
当 Ram 和 Lakshman 回来的时候，发现 Sita 已经不见了。
And then they have to search. They have to go and look. Where is she? How to find her?
他们要去找一找，看看 Sita 到底是在哪里。
So they got help from Jatayu.
他们得到了 Jatayu 的帮助。
Jatayu is a big bird, vulture bird. He tried to defend.He tried to attack Ravan, tried to save Mother Sita from Ravan, but Ravan cut off the wings of Jatayu.
Jatayu 是一只大鸟，它是一只秃鹰，它在跟 Ravan 呢打仗，想试图拯救西塔母亲，但是 Ravan 呢砍掉了它的翅膀。
So Lord, when Lord Rama found Jatayu, Lord Rama did the last rites. He did the cremation for Jatayu.
当主 Rama 找到 Jatayu 的时候，为他举行了最后的葬礼。
And he understood Mother Sita had been taken by Ravan, so he has to search out Ravan, and he got the help from the monkeys and the bears, the Vamanas, and with the help of Hanuman, they found out Mother Sita is in Lanka.
于是 Ravan 从贾塔语呢得到了消息，知道他是被 Ravan 抢走了，他就想要去找他。他得到了猴子们的帮助，而且还有狗熊们的帮助，他们是 Vamanas。
So,
他们一起去要 Lanka， 从哈努曼呢知道要他被抢到了 Lanka 去。
So Lord Rama came there to the ocean, and the ocean was blocking the path to Lanka. Lord Rama was so angry that just from his glance, the whole ocean became hot.
主 Ram 到了海边。而主 Ram 非常的愤怒，只是通过他的瞥视，整个的大海都变得非常的热。
We should also be like that when we think how demons like Ravan have taken Lakshmi away from Ram.
我们也应该是像那样的，我们应该就是，在对待 Lakshmi 的方面，应该注意到不要被这种像 Ravan 一样的恶魔给拿走。
Just like Lord Ram was so angry, the whole ocean became hot. We should be angry to see all the Lakshmi in the hands of so many Ravans.
那么就像是 Ram 他表现的一样，在海边呢，他就是非常的愤怒。我们也要注意，我们要看到所有的这些像 Ravan 一样的恶魔，把所有的 Lakshmi 都给拿走了。
So, the god of the ocean came before Lord Ramachandra and begged him that before.That you please cross the ocean, you construct a bridge.
海神来到了主 Ram 的面前，说：“你要是想过这个大海的话呢，你应该建一座桥。”
So Lord Ramachandra began. He took the help of all the bears and monkeys, and they all began to help to construct the bridge.
于是 Ram 接受了所有的猴子还有狗熊们的帮助，他们开始建一座跨海的大桥。
But before they did that.Lord Ramachandra, first of all, worshipped Lord Shiva.
但在做这件事情之前，主 Rama 先崇拜了主 Shiva.
Maybe you often see the picture. Lord Ramachandra is at the shore of the ocean, going to cross the ocean, and he's worshipping a Shiva Linga.
可能你们见过这样的一幅图片，也就是主 Ramachandra 要跨过这个大海之前呢，他有一个 Shiva Linga， 他在崇拜这个 Shiva Linga.
So people wonder.Lord Rama is supposed to be God. Why is he worshipping Lord Shiva?
人们就在奇怪，主 Rama 他是至尊人格守神，他为什么要崇拜主 Shiva 呢？
Maybe Shiva is greater than Rama.
也许 Shiva 比 Rama 更伟大。
Prabhupada said, no. He said, Lord Rama is telling Shiva, I'm going to kill your devotee.
帕帕说不，其实呢，主 Rama 是在告诉 Shiva, 我要杀了你的奉献者。
Ravan was a devotee of Shiva.
Ravan 是主 Shiva 的一位奉献者。
So Lord Ramachandra is worshipping Shiva. They tell him, I'm going there to kill your devotee.
所以主 Ramachandra 崇拜主 Shiva 的目的是说，告诉他我要去杀你的奉献者了。
So with the help of all the bears and monkeys, they crossed over to Lanka.
这样在所有的狗熊还有猴子们的帮助下，他们跨海去到了 Lanka.
In the Valmiki Ramayana.It's described that it's a great distance. It's many miles across the sea to Lanka.
在 Valmiki Ramayana 之中提到，要是跨越海洋抵达 Lanka 是很大的、很长的一个距离，需要很多很多英里。
Today, people say that they say the kingdom of Lanka is the island Sri Lanka.
如今人们说那个 Lanka 就是目前的斯里兰卡这个岛。
But that Sri Lanka is not very far away from India.
但是那个斯里兰卡离印度并不远。
And some people say that in the times of Lord Rama and the Treta Yuga, that kingdom which is today known as Sri Lanka, that was all part of India.
因为有的人说，在 Treta Yuga， 在 主 Ramachandra 的那个时代，在白银年代，作为 Lanka 的那个地方，其实是印度的一部分。
And the actual kingdom of Ravan is far across the ocean.
而 Ravan 呢，他的这个地，他的这个据点，实际上是在大海里。
So there's some things difficult to understand.
有一些事情是很难理解的。
No. But Prabhupada said, don't disturb the faith of the common people. The people have faith that Ravan's kingdom is there in Lanka.
但是帕帕说呢，我们不要去干扰人们的信心，因为人们一般的他们有信心，认为 Ravana 的国度就在 Lanka， 在斯里兰卡。
There was a great king called Maharaj Kulasekar.
有一个伟大的国王，他的名字叫 Kumara Kulasekar.
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 He was one of the Alwars. There were great kings in South India, a very long time ago, even before.Lord Rama.
他是一位奥瓦尔，他们是南印度的非常有力量的国王，他们的存在是早于主 Rama 的存在。
So 12 Alwars, they are incarnations of the different paraphernalia of Lord Krishna.
这十二位奥瓦尔实际上是主 Krishna 的不同的随身用品的化身。
Maharaj Kulasekar is the incarnation of the Kastuba gem which Krishna wears around his neck.
马哈拉是 Kulasekar， 他实际上是主 Krishna 戴在脖子上的 Kastuba 宝石。
So Maharaj Kulasekar was he would love to hear the pastimes of Lord Rama.
马哈拉是 Kulasekar， 他非常喜欢聆听主 Rama 的逍遥时光。
And when he would hear about battle between Ravan and Ram, Maharaj Kulasekar would become so excited he'd order.Get the army! Call my army out! We have to go and help Lord Ram.
当马哈迪库拉谢卡尔在聆听 Ravana 和 Rama 之间的大战的时候，他会变得非常的激动，他会站起来大喊：“赶快让我的军队准备好，我们要出发，要去帮助 Ram。”
He would be hearing the Ramayana, and he would be right. He'd be absorbed in it. Lord Ram's in trouble. We have to go and help him. We have to fight Ravan.
他听着 Ramayana， 然后就全神贯注入了迷，就说我们要去帮助 Ram， 我们要去为他而战。
Get the army out, get my horse ready. I'm going. We're going to fight.
让军队准备出发，把我的马准备好，我们马上要出去打仗了。
So they thought, oh my God, what are we going to do now?
想着怎么办？现在该怎么办
？Because he's the king, he's ordering. We have to do it.
因为他是国王，他下了命令，我们就不得不去做。
So they make a They do a trip. They send some people. You go ahead, quick. A few of you go ahead, and then turn back and come and meet us.
然后他们先派出几个人去做了一个把戏，说你们几个人先到前面去，然后很快的再折回来见我们。
And when we're on the road, you can meet us and you can tell us that the battle is already over and Ram has already defeated Ravan.
而你们见到我们之后呢，你们就可以给我们汇报这个消息，这个战争已经结束了，主 Rama 已经击败了 Ravan。
And this way they could go back home. But Maharaj Kulasekhar or something, he's so fired up. He get to the ocean, he just go right into the sea, he just go right in the ocean. So he was really a great Rambhakta. And Lord Rama, he took advantage of all these bears. They didn't have any weapons. Ravana had a very opulent kingdom with very sophisticated weapons.
Ravana 充分利用了这些狗熊，但是他们没有任何武器，而Ravana他有非常富裕的国度，而且他们有各种装备精良的武器。
But the bears just had trees and rocks.
但这些狗熊们，他们只有树木，还有岩石。
The monkeys, Hanuman, they were all just fighting using trees and rocks for their weapons.
像哈努曼这样的猴子们，他们打仗只能用一些树木还有石头作为武器。
But they were able to defeat the army of Ravana.
但是他们能够击败Ravana的军队。
So there was one brother of Ravana who left the army of Ravana. He didn't want to fight with Ravana. He left his brother and he came to join Lord Rama's army.
Ravana 有一个弟弟，他不愿意跟 Ravana 一起作战，于是他离开了 Ravana， 他想来加入 Ravana 的队伍。
Vibhishana, right. So Vibhishana, he was the brother of Ravana and he came to join Lord Rama. At first Hanuman was doubtful. He thought, I don't know, we should not accept him. He's a demon, he's from Ravana's family. We shouldn't take him in our side. But Lord Rama said, no, no, we have to take him.
Vibhishana is Ravana's brother. But at the beginning, Hanuman had a question. He was from the enemy's army. He was Ravana's brother. We couldn't accept him. But Lord Rama said, no, no, we have to accept him.
Lord Rama vowed, anybody who utters my name one time, I can never give them up. I have to give them
up.
So, Vibhishana, he became the king after Ravana was killed by Rama.
当 Ravana 被 Rama 所杀了之后， Vibhishana 他成为国王。
And he was told also that he should regularly go to Jagannath Puri and worship Lord Jagannath. So it said in Jagannath Puri, there's a ring there. It's a huge ring. It said, this is the ring of
Vibhishana.
From Treta Yuga, people were really big.
来自于 Treta Yuga， 那个时候人们的身材也很高大。
So in this way Rama got back Mother Sita, but Lord Rama is concerned that people will think my wife has not been chased because she's been touched by another man.
Rama 于是赢回了 Sita， 但是他有一些顾虑，因为他担心人们会说，哦，Sita 已经被另外一个男人所触碰过了。
She's not been staying in my home. This Ravana kidnapped her, took her to his home. She's been living there with Ravana. So it's very bad for a king to have a wife who is not chaste. So Lord Rama built the fire. And he told his Sita, enter the fire.
他告诉西塔说进入火中。
This is to test her chastity.
这是为了考验她的贞洁。
So Mother Sita entered into the fire, and from out the fire, the other side of the fire, came out, because it was the Maya Sita who entered into the fire, and the actual Sita, Mother Sita, who is the pure transcendental Mother Sita, she came out carried by the fire god Agni.
于是西塔母亲进入火中，然后从火的另外一头出来了。但实际上是玛雅西塔进入火中，然后从火的另外一边出来的是由火神阿格尼德瓦所承载的真正的纯粹的超然的西塔。
So in this way, Lord Rama took Sita, the actual Sita, back to Ayodhya, they went back to Ayodhya, and Lord Rama was crowned as the king.
这样，主阿玛就带着西塔，带着真正的西塔回到了 Ayodhya。之后，主阿玛被加冕为王。
But Lord Rama was always worried about what do people think about him? What are they saying about him?
但是主阿玛一直很关心人们对他有什么样的意见，大家对他有什么样的看法。
And he had six different spies go out every day to go around the kingdom and listen to what people were saying about him.
他有六个间谍，每一天他都会派这些间谍出去，在他的王国里巡查，看看大家对他有什么意见。
So it happened, there was one of the spies, he heard this washerman say to his wife,
结果有一个间谍就听到一个洗衣工对自己的妻子讲话。
And he said to his wife, Lord Rama may take his wife back after she's been in another man's home, but I'm not taking you.
这个洗衣工对他的妻子说，可能主 Rama 会接受他已经去了其他男人家里的妻子再回来。但是我不会再接受你了。
And he said this again and again. The spy was listening and he was shocked to hear.
他反反复复地说着这番话，而这个间谍听到了这番话之后，感觉非常震惊。
How will he ever tell Lord Ramachandra that somebody in his kingdom is talking about him like this?
他就想着，我怎么能告诉 Ramachandra， 居然在他的国度里有人这样议论他呢？
So he didn't want to tell Lord Rama. He went back and he didn't say anything. But Lord Rama is omniscient, and he could understand something has happened.
他回去之后呢，他不想告诉主 Rama， 所以他什么都没有说。但是主 Rama 因为他是无所不知的，所以他知道发生了一些事情。
So he asked the spy, "What happened? What did you hear?"
于是他问这个间谍。怎么回事？你到底听到了什么
？So the spy told Lord Rama, "I heard this washerman say to his wife."
这个间谍说，我听到了一个洗衣工在跟他的妻子讲话。
He told his wife, "Lord Rama may take his wife back. I'm not taking you back."
他听到洗衣工跟他的妻子说，主 Rama 可以把他的妻子接回来，但是我不会再接受你了。
I cannot be like Lord Rama.
我不能够跟 Ram 一样。
And when Lord Rama heard this, he fainted on the floor.
当 Ram 听到这番话的时候，他晕倒在地。
And when he came back to consciousness, he told Lakshman, he said, "Take Sita to the ashram of Valmiki."
当他苏醒过来之后，他告诉 Lakshman， 带着 Sita 去 Valmiki Muni 的 ashram。
Now Mother Sita was 5 months pregnant.
现在 Sita 母亲已经怀孕五个月了。
And Lord Rama sending her away.
而主 Rama 让他离开。
Go to the ashram of Valmiki.
去 Valmiki 的 ashram.
And leave her there.
把他留在那。
Some people complain. What kind of man is this? What kind of husband is this?
经常有人会抱怨说，这是什么男人？这是什么丈夫？
What kind of etiquette is this?
这是什么礼节？
You send your wife away when she's pregnant.
当你的妻子怀孕了之后，你就把她赶走吗
？So Mother Sita anyway went to the ashram of Valmiki, stayed there, and she delivered her two sons, Lav and Kush.
无论如何，西塔母亲去了 Valmiki 的 ashram， 她住在那里，生下了一对双胞胎 ，Lav 和 Kush.
Then she entered into the earth.
然后她进入大地之中。
She was born from the earth. She returned back.
她是从大地里生出来的，所以她也返回了大地。
She disappeared from the world.
她从这个世界上消失了。
So Lord Ramachandra is the king and he has no wife.
主 Ramachandra 作为一个国王，他没有妻子。
But he has to do many rituals as a king.
但作为一个国王，他要举行很多的仪式。
But when you do rituals, the king has to have his wife by his side.
但是当一个国王举行仪式的时候，必须身边有妻子的陪伴。
The king cannot be a brahmachari.
国王不能成为一个 brahmachari.
He has to be a married man with his wife.
他必须是一个居士，有妻子。
There's no wife.
但是他没有妻子了。
So he has a deity.
于是他做了一尊神像。
Mother Sita was there in the form of a deity.
西塔母亲作为一尊神像的这种临在。
And whenever they would do rituals, Lord Ram would sit with the deity Mother Sita.
而每当他需要做仪式的时候，主 Rama 就让西塔母亲的神像陪伴在自己的身边。
That was in Treta Yuga.
是在 Treta Yuga.
Now in Kali Yuga, it happened.Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Lord Ramachandra comes as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and Sita came in the form of Vishnu Priya.
而现在是卡利 Yuga, 主 Ramachandra 作为主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 到来，而 Sita 作为 Vishnu Priya 到来。
Lord Chaitanya took sannyas, left Vishnu Priya.
主 Chaitanya 接受了 sannyas, 留下了 Vishnu Priya.
And Vishnu Priya has her husband in the form of a deity.
而 Vishnu Priya 有她的丈夫作为一尊神像的形体。
In Navadvip, there's a deity, Dameshwar Mahaprabhu.
在 Navadvip 有这样的一尊神像 ，Dameshwar Mahaprabhu.
So the situation was reversed.
因此，这种情况反转了过来。
The Padma Purana also describes the reason why Mother Sita had to go into exile.
Padma Purana 宇宙故事莲花之父描述了为什么 Sita 母亲要被流放。
It's described there that when Mother Sita was a young girl, she was living with her father. Her father was Maharaj Janaka. So Sita's name is Janaki.
西塔小的时候跟他的父亲加纳克马哈尔住在一起，所以他的名字也叫加纳基。
So at that time, Janaki had these two parrots talking.
在那个时候，加纳基听到有两只鹦鹉在对话。
Two parrots, they were a couple.
两只鹦鹉，他们是一对夫妇。
So the wife is talking to the husband.
妻子跟丈夫就说。
You know married life, right?So the parrot was talking to the male parrot, and he was telling about the queen and her king, and the king, and they got separated, and the king had to go and look for the queen and bring her back. And she was narrating all the pastimes of Lord Ramachandra.
雌鹦鹉就在跟这个雄鹦鹉讲话，他就说有一个国王，有一个王后，他们住在一起，然后分开了。
So Sita's a young girl and she heard the parrots talking and she was listening. She thought, well, this is very interesting. Where did you hear all this from?
Sita 是一个小姑娘，她听到了之后觉得非常有意思，她就说你是从哪个地方听到这一切的？
So the female parrot said, well, we heard it from Valmiki. We go to Valmiki's ashram and we heard everything from him.
雌鹦鹉说：“我们是从王密提那里听到的。我们去了王密提的 ashram， 从他那里听说了所有这一切。”王密提了解主 Rama 的所有的逍遥时光，甚至是在这些逍遥时光发生之前，他就知道。
The pastimes of Lord Rama are eternal.
主 Rama 的逍遥时光是永恒的。
And so the parrot was talking, telling him.And Janaki was so attracted, she told her servants, get this bird, I have to have this bird, get this bird, I want to keep this bird with me.
这只鹦鹉在讲话，然后呢 ,Janaki 非常的受到了吸引，于是他就告诉他的仆人说，把这只鸟给我抓起来，我要把这只鸟留在身边。
So the servants brought that bird for her, and the bird pleaded with the Janaki, with Sita, and the bird said,Look, you don't keep me here. I can't stay with you in the palace. I'm from the forest. I want to go back to the forest.
仆人把这只鸟带到了西塔，就是带到加纳提面前。但是这只鹦鹉，这只鸟在祈求加纳提说：“你不能让我待在这里，住在宫殿里。我是属于森林的，我应该住在森林里。”
She said, "I'm my husband there. My husband wants we should be together, and I'm already pregnant."
他说我有丈夫，我的丈夫也在森林里等我，而且我怀孕了。
But Sita said, no, I want you here. I want you here to tell me about these stories about Rama.
但是西塔说不，我想聆听，我想听你给我讲所有关于主 Rama 的这些逍遥时光。
I'm not going to let you go back to the forest.
我才不让你回森林里去呢。
So the male parrot came.
然后这个雄鹦鹉来了。
And the male parrot.You're not letting my wife come. She's already pregnant. You're not letting us enjoy our family life together. So you will get the same treatment in the future.
熊鹦鹉来了之后就告诉西塔说，你不让我的妻子回来跟我一起团聚，享受家庭的生活，那么将来你也会遭到同样的下场。
This bird actually became this washerman.
这只鸟后来就成了洗衣工。
That washerman who was saying that, I'm not taking you back. Ram may take his wife back. I'm not taking you back.
这个洗衣工就跟他的妻子说，我不会接受你回来了。Ram 可以接受他的妻子回来，可是我不接受你回来。
So this washerman, he was actually the male parrot.
因此，这个洗衣工就是当初的那只雄鹦鹉。
Came in the form of the washerman to speak the harsh words about Lord Ramachandra.
他以洗衣工的身份来讲述关于 Ramachandra 的很刻薄的话语。
And this is why Mother Sita had to go in exile.
这也是为什么西塔母亲不得不被流放。
There's a reason for everything.
所有的一切都是有原因的。
For the pastimes of Lord Rama, they teach us a lot about the Supreme Lord.
主 Rama 的逍遥时光教了我们很多关于至尊主的方方面面。
His wonderful pastimes with his devotees.
他跟他的奉献者们之间的奇妙的逍遥时光。
Lord Rama has his kingdom in the spiritual world in Ayodhya, which is connected to Vaikuntha.
主 Rama 在灵性世界也有他的地方，叫做 Ayodhya， 这个是跟 Vaikuntha 相关联的。
And there the mood is Dasharatha.
在那个地方的情感是 Dasharatha。
Because Lord Rama is a king, everybody is a servant.
因为主 Rama 是国王，所有其他的人全都是仆人。
So this is Ramlila.
这就是 Ramlila.
Being a servant. All the Rambhattas, like Hanuman, they're servants. They have the mood to give service to Lord Rama.
所有的这些巴卡们奉献者们，比如说哈努曼，他们都是仆人，他们的存在是为了给主 Ramachandra 做服务。
We see Lord Hanuman always kneeling with his body, just waiting for service from Lord Ram.
我们看到哈努曼的姿势一直是单膝跪地，双手合十，等待着为主 Ram 来做服务。
Even though he knows Lakshmi and Narayana are the supreme form, he only wants to worship the Lord in the form of Sita and Ram.
即使他知道 Lakshmi 和 Narayana 他们是主的永恒的形象，但是他仍然只想崇拜 Sita 还有 Ram 的这个形象。
So, Lord Rama, the holy name of Lord Ram.It's described that Lord Shiva's wife, Parvati, she was going to chant the 1,000 names of Vishnu.
主 Rama 的圣名也得到了描述。主 Shiva 的妻子 Parvati, 她要唱诵主 Vishnu 的一千个名字。
But Lord Shiva was hungry. He didn't want to wait for his wife to chant 1,000 names of Vishnu before he ate.
那么主希望饿了，他不想等着他的妻子唱诵完主Vishnu的一千个名字才能吃东西。
He told his wife, "You don't need to chant the 1,000 names of Vishnu, just chant the holy name of Lord Ram."
他告诉他的妻子说，你不必去唱诵Vishnu的一千个名字，你只要唱诵 Ram 的名字就可以了。
Rame Rame Namo Rame Sahasranama Bistuyam Shri Ramanama Varani. Lord Shiva is saying, "My dear beautiful wife, with a beautiful face. He said, just chant the name of Lord Ram. It's equal to 1,000 names of Vishnu.
主希瓦就告诉他的妻子说，我美丽的有着美丽面庞的非常美丽的妻子啊，你只要唱诵主 Ram 的圣名，就相当于唱诵了主 Vishnu 的一千个名字。
So all the Rambhattas, they know that verse.
所有的 Rambhattas 都知道这一时节。
Just like we all know Hare Krishna, they all know this. Rame Rame Namo Rame.
就像是我们都知道 Hare Krishna Mantra 一样，他们都知道这个 Rame Rame Namo Rame
Sahasranama Bistuyam
Sahasranama Bistuyam
Shri Rama Nama Varani
Shri Rama Nama Varani.
Of course, they don't know that three names of Rama is equal to one name of Krishna.
当然了，他们不知 道三遍 Ram 的名字相当于 Krishna 的一遍的名字。他们崇拜 Ram 就很高兴了。
The Sri Vaishnavas, the Ram, they're actually meant to be Ram Bhaktas.
Sri Vaishnava, 他们都是 Ram Bhakta.
They worship also, they worship Lakshmi Narayan, they worship Lord Nrsingadev.
他们崇拜 Lakshmi Narayan, 他们崇拜 Nrsingadev.
There's a famous pastime. There was one Brahmana every day used to go to see Lord Rama.And he would not eat his food until he first of all offered obeisances in the morning to Lord Rama.
有这样的一个故事，一位 Brahmana 他每天都会去见主 Rama。那么如果他要是没有向主 Rama 先顶拜，他就不会吃东西。
So it happened sometimes Lord Rama would go out on tour and go and visit different places.
结果有的时候主 Rama 就要出去去访问不同的地方。
And so the Brahmana would come, he couldn't offer obeisances to Lord Rama, he would fast. And Lord Rama would come back after several days, and the Brahmana had been fasting for several days. So Lord Rama was very sorry when he heard this, and he told the Brahmana, he said, my dear Brahmana friend,You don't need to fast, he said, and he gave him a deity of Lord Rama.
主 Rama 听到这番话之后，他觉得很难过，很难过，然后他就做了一尊自己的神像送给了这个 Rama.
This deity of Lord Rama actually came from the sun god.
主 Rama 的这尊神像实际上来自于太阳神。
Lord Rama appears in the sun dynasty of the sun god.
主 Rama 显现在太阳神的王朝。
Lord Krishna came in the dynasty from the moon.
主 Krishna 来自于月亮王朝。
But Lord Rama is from the sun god. So the sun god actually had this deity of Lord Rama. And this deity, somehow it came to the palace of Maharaj Ramachandra. Maharaj Ramachandra gave it to this Brahmana.
主 Rama 属于太阳王朝，而太阳神他就有这尊主 Rama 的神像。后来呢，这尊神像就到了主 Ramachandra 的宫廷。于是主 Rama 就把这尊神像送给了这位 Brahmana。
So the Brahmana could offer his obeisances to the deity every day, didn't need to fast anymore.
这样，这位 Brahmana 可以每天向这尊神像顶拜，就用不着再戒食了。
And then this deity was passed to, I think it came somehow it came to Hanuman, and then it came to Jagannath Puri, and then it came to Madhvacharya's place at Udupi.
这尊神像后来被送给了哈努曼，然后从哈努曼又到了加格纳托瑞，从加格纳托瑞又被传到了在乌杜比的玛德瓦查尔雅的这个传承之中。
Yeah, if you go to Udupi, you can see that same deity today.
如果你们去乌杜比的话，如今还可以看到同样的神像。
So, Lord Ramachandra's deity has been worshipped for hundreds of thousands of years.
因此主 Rama 的神像受到了成千上万年的崇拜
and they worship not only on this planet
而且他们不仅仅是在这个星球上崇拜
that even the sun god is worshipping
甚至太阳神也崇拜过这尊神像
Okay, any questions?
好，有什么问题吗？
这个西塔是幸运女神她本可以超越那个雄鹦鹉的诅咒但她接受了这个就是，但在这个诅咒接受结果，肯定对主 Rama 唱歌是一个完美的丈夫才能怀孕，因为他怀孕的时候就把他妻子放到身上。他这个怎么能回答这里的疑问呢？他是一个完美的人，主 Rama 才是完美。他是一个很好的丈夫，把妻子救了回来，但怀孕的时候把他扔了，是因为诅咒。完了以后会说。幸运女神和自尊的守神怎么会她可以超越诅咒这是一个逍遥时光还是什么
Well, this is the Leela. It's an eternal Leela. You know, Lord Rama's pastimes are eternal and he comes many times. It's not that he just comes one time. He comes in many different kalpas and different madhvantaras will come. And there will be some variations in the pastime, but the general mood, the general pastimes are pretty much the same.
这是一个永恒的逍遥时光，主 Ram 的逍遥时光全都是永恒的，他在这一天，他每很多很多不同的 Kalpa 都会来上演，然后就会有这样的情况。
So we have to accept that this separation increases, just like Lord Ramachandra came here in Mayapur, he came to Modadruma Dweep.
Ramachandra 曾经来到了 Mayapur, 他到的是 Modadruma Dweep.
And he was in Modadruma Dweep and he was appreciating the beauty of the place, so many nice trees, the beautiful flowers, and the birds are singing, and there was water, crystal clear water. He was thinking, oh, such a beautiful place. But he was thinking and enjoying the beauty, he was smiling to himself.
当主要参照在 Model 中文对比的时候，他非常的欣赏这些地方的美丽，他在看这么美丽的树木，然后还有很多的鲜花，还有清澈见底的这个河流，于是他在微笑，他自己在对着自己微笑。
So Mother Sita saw her husband smiling to himself and she asked him, what are you thinking, my dear husband?
当西特母亲看到主拉姆在对着自己微笑的时候呢，她就说：“你在想什么，我亲爱的丈夫？”
And he said, "My dear wife," he said, "I'm thinking how in the Kali Yuga we will take birth here."
他然后呢，他说：“我亲爱的妻子，我在想着在 Kali Yuga 我们两个人都会出生在这里。”
But she said, "Yeah, but what's so giving you so much pleasure?"
然后他就问说：“那到底是什么给了你这么多的快乐？”
Yes, he said, in the Kali Yuga, he said, I will take sannyas, and I will leave home.
他说是的，在 Kali Yuga, 我要接受 sannyas, 我要离开家。
And Sita said, oh, you will take sannyas and leave me, and you're smiling?
然后 Sita 说，哦，你要当 sannyasi, 你要离开我，你还在笑。
And Lord Ramachandra said, yes, my dear wife, because by separation, we will increase the longing for each other.
然后主让穿着说：“是的，我亲爱的妻子，因为通过分离，我们将增加彼此的渴望。”
And the feeling of separation will lead to again union.
而分离的情感再一次会导致我们的团聚。
So, the separation, Lord Chaitanya was separated, but then.They will return to the spiritual world.
这就是分离，主彩丹给大家带来分离的感受，但他们会再次重返灵性世界。
So Lord Krishna separates himself from the devotees to increase their attachment.
主 Krishna 让自己跟奉献者有分离的这种情况，是为了增加奉献者对他的依附。
So that they can again come together and enjoy.
这样大家可以再一次团聚在一起，一起高高兴兴的享受。
So the separation leads to union.
因此分离会导致团聚。
我想问一个，当西塔母亲对拉什曼说了那么尖刻的话语的时候，那算不算是一种对拉什曼的冒犯？
Well, that's family affairs.
这是他们的家庭事务。
Yeah. The wife, the harsh words of the woman, you know, women can have that sharp tongue.
女人就这样。
Sometimes very harshly.
女人她们说这种刻薄的话语，她们有这种尖刻的舌头，她们有时候可以说这样的话。
Of course, you ladies would never speak like that.
当然了，你们这些女士们永远不会那样讲话的，是吧？
But, sometimes it happens, you know.
但有的时候会发生这样的情况。
The feminine nature comes out.
当这种女性的本性展示出来的时候。
But as I said, it's also that sometimes the demigods are arranging this just to facilitate the pastime.
但是正如我提到过的，这都是半神人的安排，是为了协助逍遥时光的进行。
Just like Mantara was speaking and corrupting the mind of Kaikeyi.The demigods were speaking on their tongue.
就像是曼塔拉，他在跟 Kaikeyi 在讲话，他在，等于是污染、腐化 Kaikeyi 的心意。其实是半神人们通过他的舌头在讲话。
And so again, Mother Sita, when she says like that to Lakshman, the demigods, their influence, their to facilitate the pastime to get Lakshman away so that Ravan can kidnap Sita.
当西塔母亲在跟拉什曼说这样的话的时候，其实也是拜神人们在起作用，是因为他们想让拉什曼离开这个地方 ，Ravan 呢就可以绑架西塔。
Because the demigods are anxious, Lord Ram has to go to Lanka. He has to kill Ravan.
因为拜神人们非常的迫切，想让 Ram 去 Lanka 杀死 Ravan。
Yes.
那
个，
也许
Yoga 他们讲。
Well, Yuga avatars, they come, you know, to propagate the Yuga Dharma.
Yuga avatar 到来是为了传扬这个 Yuga Dharma.
So Treta Yuga, Yuga Dharma was.Fire sacrifice.
Treta Yuga 的 Yuga Dharma 是火祭。
Yes.
我有个问题是，我家梵谷女就是说，我们就是做好自己该做的，即使做的不完美，也比就是也远胜于就是履行他人的职责。但是在我们经常就在我们平时的现实生活当中。就是很难辨别，就是我们的职责是什么，然后别人的职责是什么，就是怎么样分辨，就是我们的职责。
Your duty is to serve Krishna.
你的职责是去服务 Krishna.
You have to see Krishna in the heart of everyone.
你应该看到 Krishna 在每一个人的内心之中。
Of course, you're a wife. You have a duty to your husband.
当然，你是一个妻子，所以你对你的丈夫有职责。
You're a mother, you have a duty to your child.
你是一个母亲，你应该对你的孩子履行职责。
You're a Chinese, you have a duty to China.
中国人，你是中国要负起责任来。